Hello everybody, this is Money Mom. Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to talk about why do we love to thrive on drama and conflict. Let's get started and talk about it. Not saying we all do, but I think, if you don't mind me saying, many of us have been guilty of this at some point in our life, and I've heard many say from things that I've read and videos I've watched that it is natural for us to thrive on conflict, drama, and negativity. Well, why is that? I wrote down some reasons, kind of thinking of why I think we do it and what can we do about it. So one of the reasons why I think people kind of thrive on fear-based talk, drama, conflict, getting themselves involved in other people's business and life is because, number one, people may not have enough fulfilling hobbies or activities in their own life, and they have too much time on their hands. I don't know about you guys, but I am a really busy person. I know we're all busy and all of our time is valuable, every one of us. But I'm quite busy with all the activities I do. So to be honest with you, I really don't have a lot of time to get myself all enmeshed in types of drama and conflict. So I do think that's one reason. Number two, it's exciting. It's kind of interesting to talk about other people. And one of the reasons is many of us, and it's in our nature, to compare ourselves to others. For example, we always, and you've heard women say this before, that many times if you get together with an old friend and they're heavier than you, part of you secretly likes that they've gained weight and you've lost weight. I know that sounds cruel, but many times a lot of people are like that. We compare ourselves to others, or we say things like, well, I wouldn't put up with that. Well, they should do this. Well, they need to do that. And it's interesting and exciting to talk about what's going on in other people's lives and compare it to yours, because it gets the focus off us in areas we need to fix in our own life. And maybe each and every one of us have been guilty of this. And by the way, I'm not accusing any of you having any of these attributes. I'm being honest to say that, guess what? I feel like I've matured a lot, but in times in my life, I know I've had some of these attributes, just to be frank with you. So I think basically people really want to get the focus off them, talk about others and other things going on, so they don't work on things that they need to work on themselves. That's number two. Number three, basically many people thrive on being in crisis mode because it brings more attention to themselves. Have you ever had somebody, what they do, one up you? If you said, yes, I fell down and hurt myself, or I had this particular thing happen to me. And they'll say, well, if you think that's bad, this is what happened to me. You know, that type of thing. People many times like to live in crisis mode because it gives them attention. And last but not least, we are basically accustomed to negativity. I've heard that 70 to 80% of our thoughts tend to be negative. We tend to thrive off that, and we rethink these negative thoughts over and over again. And it really does take some work to change our mindset to be more positive and to talk about more positive things. One of the things that I've been doing a lot lately is a lot of what I call, quote, self-talk. And I'll be honest with you, there's been a couple times I've been tempted to tell folks or some of my friends some things. And before I speak, I've been really asking myself this question. I've been, even though it doesn't sound like it on videos, I've been slower to speak. And I've been doing a lot of self-reflection saying, you know what, Dawn, do you really need to say whatever statement it is or talk about whatever particular topic it is? Is it going, what's purpose is it going to serve? What can happen? Because once we get those words out there, I mean, thoughts are just thoughts, and hopefully nobody can read our thoughts. But if we say words out there, you can't take those back. Or if you put something in an email or a post on social media, you can't take it back. You can go back maybe and delete it, but once it's out there, it's out there. So I've been really doing a lot of self-reflecting on that and asking myself that. So what can we do about this? I mean, like I said, a lot of this stuff is in our nature, and even though these are negative qualities, what can we do? The first thing, and this is one thing I've been doing, I know I've already mentioned this, I've been reading a lot of really good books. Some are fictional that just bring joy to me and relax me, which is really good because it relaxes my mind. And some are books that are helpful. I know I think I mentioned this, but I'm reading Atomic Habits right now. I really like it. It's one of the best books that I've read. I'll be doing a video or a book review on that book. Normally I don't do that on this channel, but I really feel that this book has some excellent information. Let me know if any of you've read it. So basically, reading, also surrounding yourself with like-minded people that are wanting to change themselves and the world to be a better place. Also, another thing I'm doing is taking courses on some of these things, like I'm taking a course on happiness, things that I can do to improve myself, to be a better person in the world, and surrounding myself with wonderful people. One of the other things I'm doing is one of the friends that I walk with, we actually have had some really good talks, and we both agreed there are certain topics that we've chosen not to talk about unless it's something really important we need to know. So we have our, quote, trigger subjects, and so there's certain things that we're not talking about, and it's making us have a more enjoyable time. We're looking forward to what we can do to make a difference in the world. So these are some things that you can do. Now, what do you do if you're surrounded around people that do kind of like to cause some conflict and drama and like you to get them all enmeshed in their life and they want to be involved in yours? I know I've kind of mentioned this before, but you can, number one, act disinterested. But even besides doing that, one of the things that I'm doing is if I am around people that are kind of fear-based and really like to get into, you know, negative talking and just basically things that drain you, and if you're around somebody, whether it's work or whatever, I may bring up something about, hey, guess what? You know, what, are you reading any good books? I change the subject, and then say, well, I want to tell you about this book I'm reading. Well, when you start talking about, hey, I'm building better habits and things like that, and you're not kind of getting involved in some of the things they're talking about, they will make an excuse and not talk to you. They actually really either hang up the phone if you're on the phone, or they basically end the conversation if they see that you're not engaging. And one of the tips, I know it doesn't have to kind of go with this topic, but I feel really led to say it. I know many of us, when we're involved in people that like drama and conflict and, you know, like, you know, different types of, you know, video or social media posts that involve all that type of thing, and people like to engage you in, you know, defending and arguing, basically, one of the toughest things to do is allow people to think whatever they want to about you. Because you could defend yourself all day, but we can't change other people. We can only change us. So, and one other thing I wanted to mention is I was thinking about many videos out there, social media posts. If we started putting things in the subject line such as, oh, my life is going great, how many people click on those types of videos? Many people want to look at the videos where people see people's lives falling apart because for whatever reason, it makes them feel better. Don't know why. Maybe you guys could, you know, fill me in on that one. I don't know about you. The older I get, the more peace I want, the less drama I want, the less conflict I want, and the more I want to improve myself to be the best version of me I can be. Let me know what you think of this topic. You know I love your comments. And by the way, I'll put some other videos at the end of this one I think you may find interesting and basically have some comment or some subject matter similar to this. And also, if you want more personal videos, please consider supporting me on Patreon. That's all for now. I love you, appreciate you, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.